Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop board game bag check. I am Mo2zano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I want to do for you tonight is show you what you get in the box and let you make an informed decision about a Canadian game. Note, I am Canadian myself from Windsor, Ontario. Always happy to promote other Canadians. And this goes out to Inside Up Games. The game in particular here is Block and Key. Block and Key. Very shiny game with a lot of gold UV coating from Canadian publisher Inside Up Games. This is a very unique spatial recognition game. It's one of those games where you're putting stuff on a board trying to get it to match cards. There's a few of those out there. This one looks really neat. Features a nice 3D board and some of the chunkiest, most physical, great feeling polyominoes I've ever seen in a game. Now, I do have to thank Inside Up Games for letting us take a review copy of this home at Origins. I have not played this game, but we did do, I wouldn't even call it a demo. We had someone from Inside Up walk over to a table where this was set up and show us how to place a couple different blocks and claim a couple cards. So I got like the briefest overview of this game. So please don't take anything I'm saying tonight as any form of teach of Block and Key. Now, this board game does play 1 to 4 players. It says age 14 plus. That seems very high to me from what I saw of the game, but maybe I'm wrong on there. This is designed by David Van Druin with art by Eddie Vowles. 20 to 40 minute playtime. So fairly nice, quick one. This one looks like it's going to be great for convincing your non-gaming friends or non-hobby gaming friends to play with you. So step one, though, is going to be to cut the shrink and get this open. Okay, I didn't realize this, but instead of a box, we have a sleeve. Not a huge fan of sleeves. So you can kind of see there's, again, the UV coating's kind of nice. The torches are UV. But sleeves, not a huge fan of sleeves. Oh, very thin sleeve too. All right, well, sleeve comes off. And we get the board. I guess I get it because, oh wow, the UV coating's even on the board. You can see my light reflecting there. Okay, that's kind of neat. And then the bottom, this is also part of the game. This is where your market is, where you're going to draft things, and where the card deck goes. And this... Oh, these are placement rules. So you got... These are actually the placement rules for placing bricks. They have to at least be diagonal. I'm not sure what that's trying to... I think it's showing the fact they have to be taller than any other ones. And the gaps underneath are okay, but overhangs are bad. I don't know. Is it the same thing? Yeah, it's the same thing on all the sides. Oh, okay. This is making funky noises. Okay, let's take a look inside. We have the instructions on top in Canadian and French, English and French, I probably should say, and German. And then we have the stuff. Okay, no insert or anything to organize this. Handwritten script looking. Okay, that didn't stay. That's just the intro and the cover, so that's cool. I don't know if that's an overview. Oh, what the heck? Okay. Meet weird fold out instructions. And there's like the real cover. What a bizarre. Okay. Interesting choices. How to build the ruins. So it's like all the examples are over here and then the rules are over here. How to claim cards. So it's, this is it. This is so like 3 pages and then there's the solo mode and then other languages. Okay. So not a lot in here, but man, weird choice with that front fold out. What a bizarrely designed rule book. All right. Nice summary. These are so heavy. You have no idea. Baggy. Not sure what for the cards. I guess for the cards. Then this thing, which is how you build the board. See these? again, have the UV coating. You're going to fold these and somehow put these on the corners. Why not? Let's build it. Going together pretty easy. Okay, and then the box top goes on top of this, which I apologize. It's just going to be all camera up here. So, yeah. So, there. This is the board. This is your game. Oh, obviously, it can't be picked up because then the bottom falls off. That didn't go as well as planned. You get the gist. We're just going to say that. You get the gist. So anyway, you end up with a two-layer board. This is on the bottom. This is where you're going to draft stuff. That's on top. That's where the blocks are going to go. You have the instructions. You have this bag, which I'll get to in a minute. This sleeve. Not a fan of that. Let's open this stuff up. A unique cube with all colors on all sides. I think I saw this in the solo rules. So I think these are ceramic, like clay. They are, it's chunky. There. I think that was probably loud enough for you to be able to hear it. And they fit on here, right? On the grid. Blocks. Then you got a bunch of blocks in various colors, in various polyomino shapes. I'm just going to dump these on top. And again, you can kind of hear it. And you're going to place blocks. Now, the whole neat thing in this game, of course, is you can only see from one side, and you're trying to match the patterns on cards, which I'll open up the cards. So, promos, right? Come check out these other games like Sildy Builder, The Ancient World, Summit, Sea Change, and I can't remember what the Seven Souls. Seven Souls was neat. Played that one. Some end game scoring cards for each of the colors. Then the rest of these cards, which I'm not sure why these are different from these cards. Okay, I don't know why there's two different symbols on the cards, but again, this is not meant to teach. So you're looking for that pattern, but from your side of the board. You're looking for that pattern from your side of the board. You're looking for that pattern. And that's all these are, is various patterns that you are hoping to see while looking at the board in this game. So there was a baggie for these, I remember. That's right here. I'm going to use it. Card quality is surprisingly thin, but they do have the UV spotting on it. So that's interesting. So yes, these just fit back in there. Nice. Then again, we have the polyominoes in the other colors. Which what I'm going to do is technically you draw them out of this bag. So I'm just going to dump the polyominoes in here. Because then the game will be almost set up and ready to play. So I'll grab some of these out. Man, they are chunky and nice. They feel so good. So again, I'm building this way. But in the game, you would be building up and trying to see things. And they'd have to fit the grid and so on. We've got a total of four colors. Which I think are stick out pretty well. I am assuming someone who knows about vision issues took a look at these and okayed them. I would hope so. I do not have any color-based vision issues, so I could not confirm myself. So there we have all the different colors. Kind of see them next to each other. Contrast seems really good to me. These are all going to go in this bag, which the game provides. This says block and key. And this is actually like embroidered in gold. That's actually nice. You can kind of see. You can see the backing in there. It's a nice touch. So we're going to toss these back in. He's very loud. Oh, that is, it's heavy. Then what I'm going to do is I ended up putting the lid over top of the bottom in potentially a bad way that they don't want to come apart. Here we go. Whoa, Kickstarter backers. Here you go. Thank you, all you people, for making this game a reality. So I'm just going to show this off quick because what you would do here is you would draft and you'd have these sitting here. Right, and then these sitting here, and so on. And they don't have to be the colors that are in the same rows there. Right, these go here. The cards I had earlier are going to go in the two deck piles on here. This is the bottom layer. And then you would have the top layer that you're building on. There you go. Block and Key, Inside Up Games, Canadian company. Always appreciate seeing more CanCon, more Canadian games out there. So chunky. Oh, can hear it. Oh, it's so chunky. All right, what I need over here, though, is the instructions and the legs. Yeah, that fits back in well enough. So then you have the hard decision of, do I put this on my shelf like this? Or do I re-sleeve it? Not a fan of sleeves, sorry. I'm re-sleeving it for now. There you go. Block and Key. Some mixed thoughts here. This is my very heavy copy of Block and Key Inside Up Games. Again, thank you, Inside Up, for the review copy. I do appreciate that. Board is better than it seemed in that video. I apologize for trying to build it here on camera, but this camera up here that I was using top down is just too close to the top. And it ends up, you can't pick it up. Once it's meant to be on a table with weight on it pushing down, which you would get from all these blocks. With the weight pushing down, I'm sure it's perfectly fine, but you cannot pick it up by the bottom layer because it's just sitting on top of little spiky bits. So that was my bad trying to even pick that up. That made a bit of a mess. Please don't see that as something bad against the game. Amazing polyominoes, like really nice, chunky, I don't know, like feels Lego quality. They're not Lego though. They don't actually lock together, but just, they feel so nice. Card quality was okay. I was surprised by the UV spotting on the cards. That's unique. Board looks nice enough. Game looks pretty cool. I am looking forward to playing it. Not a fan of this in that rulebook format with the weird fold out page. Was just messy, floppy. It was not my favorite. I'm not sure why that front part of the English part kind of flopped out there. But you know what? This doesn't seem like a game you're going to reference the rulebook very much. I have a feeling it's going to be like play it once and you'll get it. So there you have my initial thoughts and showing off what you get with a copy of Block and Key from Inside Up Games, a game I am looking forward to checking out. I like games with unique themes. Well, I guess the theme, who knows what the theme is here? It's abstract, right? I'm sure it looks like we're exploring some temple. But I like games with unique mechanics. This reminds me, I'm going to deep cut here, of a game I own called La Boca, which is a cooperative, it's a competitive game where you and your opponent are sitting opposite each other and you get a card that shows what a set of blocks are like and you have to work together to place the blocks. And then you hit a timer when you're done. I get a feel for that because you've got the thing where the board's going to look different depending on where you're sitting. Now, this is a game where you're going to have to sit on four sides of a table, so each of you can only see one side. So that's going to be an aspect. But you know what? I will talk about how well that works once I review the game, which I will be doing over at tabletopbellhop.com and on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. I got a little flustered things when things didn't quite work there. So what I would appreciate, if you dig this video, I could really use a coffee. You can do that at ko-fi.com/tabletopbellhop. And if you do, I'll share a picture of what I'm drinking in this mug. So thank you for that. Could definitely use the coffee right about now. Thank you for joining me for my unboxing of Block and Key from Inside Up Games.